Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. Hope you're all doing well. Today we have three updates for you. Let's begin with Musk's comments on Starship launch as well as recent progression at Starbase. While SpaceX is nearing the first orbital launch attempt of its Starbase prototype, CEO Elon Musk stated that Starship has a roughly 50% chance of succeeding on its debut orbital test flight, which is planned to be carried out from their South Texas site in the next month or so. During an interview at the Morgan Stanley conference back on the 7th of March, Musk stated that, "We're getting close for first orbital attempt to Starship. However, in the next month or so, we'll have our first attempt. I'm not saying it will get to orbit, but I am guaranteeing excitement, so won't be boring." In the conference, Musk reiterated SpaceX's goals to make humans multiplanetary and the hardships they're going to face in order to make the fully reusable Starship operational, which will be the most powerful rocket ever to fly in the near future, featuring about 2.5 times more thrust than Saturn V. Musk had further stated that SpaceX is building multiple Starship vehicles at a fast pace in Starbase, and they've plans to launch them in relatively quick succession over the next coming months. "So I think we've got, hopefully, about an 80% chance of reaching orbit this year. It'll probably take us a couple more years to achieve full and rapid reusability." Musk's dampened expectations ahead of Starship's highly anticipated orbital debut is not new to us. Earlier, during Falcon Heavy tests, he had stated that, "I hope it makes it far enough away from the pad that it does not cause pad damage. I would even consider that a win, to be honest." The statement isn't surprising, as failure often happens in initial flights. Moreover, as the famous phrase goes, failure is a step toward success. Starship's first flight, whether a failure or success, will put it one step forward towards being operational. After Musk shared his views on Starship flight, a lot of progress has been made in Texas Starbase. As per reports, the SpaceX engineers have nearly completed the shielding work all over the orbital launch mount using large panels, including panels with doors. Though certain gaps can be visible still now at various places, SpaceX plans to cover up those places by installing metal plates, which they're presently doing from both inside and outside of the shielding work. In the meantime, they've tested a 2-point lifter and rolled out NC-31 test nose cone to the Massey test site. They've also stacked nose cone atop ship 28 at the high bay. Back on the 10th of March, Booster 7 was removed from the orbital launch mount. It's a bit surprising why the removal was done at this point, but as per some sources, it states that the removal was done to create space for the workers to carry on the shielding work at the launch mount, as well as to continue works on some of the internal hardware near the launch clamps. Recently, it was seen that SpaceX teams have been installing huge pilings in a scrapyard. It seems that they're planning to build another mega bay, which seems quite plausible, as they'll need enough space to keep the increasing number of fully built Starships, which they're manufacturing at quite a fast rate. Moving on to our next update, SpaceX has launched a brand new Dragon cargo spacecraft to the space station and successfully landed a rocket at sea. At 8:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time on March 15th, SpaceX launched its 27th contracted cargo mission for NASA from Florida's Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. The most recent mission, CRS-27, was the third for this particular Dragon capsule and the 7th for the Falcon 9 rocket that propelled it into orbit. The booster is probably going to fly again. Just 7 minutes and 45 seconds after launch on Tuesday, it descended for a precise touchdown on the SpaceX drone ship, A Shortfall of Gravitas. That was a momentous landing for both the firm and spaceflight in general. During the CRS-27 launch webcast, SpaceX engineer Zachary Luppin said, "In an industry that has historically been male-dominated, today's recovery operations are being managed by an all-female crew. In fact, we believe it to be the first all-female crew of any kind of operation like this. And if it's not the first, then we're in great company." A total of 60 new scientific experiments are being transported on CRS-27 by Dragon, along with supplies for spacewalks, vehicle gear, and other items. The last two investigations for the tissue chips in the space project, which is collaboration between the International Space Station, National Laboratory, and the U.S. National Institutes of Health, are included among the scientific equipment. The Hunch Ball Clamp Monopod, which was made by high school students in the Houston region, will launch on CRS-27 as another research payload. Officials from the agency claimed that the monopod might make filming in space simpler. As written by a NASA official on March 9th, both studies, Cardinal Heart 2.0 and Engineered Heart Tissues 2, use small devices containing living cells that mimic functions of human tissues and organs to advance the development of treatments for cardiac dysfunction. The International Space Station Program Transportation Integration Manager for NASA, Phil Dempsey, said at a pre-launch press briefing on Monday that the astronauts requested some fresh fruit and refrigerated cheeses. Apples, blueberries, grapefruit, oranges, and cherry tomatoes are therefore on board, along with a few different cheeses. Let's move to our last segment for today. Amazon announcing a trio of satellite internet receivers that will be part of its Project Kuiper broadband service. One of SpaceX's greatest achievements, aside from building a rocket that can launch and land several times, is the Starlink satellite internet service, which today connects to every continent in the world. With the launch of Project Kuiper, Amazon's satellite internet service, the company now aims to compete in the same market. The biggest online retailer in the United States initially made Project Kuiper public in 2018, but has subsequently kept it quiet. In an effort to compete with Starlink on price, Amazon has now unveiled a trio of satellite internet receiver options. A portable satellite receiver with speeds of up to 100 megabits per second and a price of only $100 is Amazon's smallest and most cheap product. Amazon will also provide a residential service option with a $400 price tag and 400 megabits per second of connectivity, stepping up in both cost and speed. Finally, Amazon will provide their largest receiver, capable of 1 gigabit per second, for use cases in business and government. However, the cost of this item has not been made public. Even though Amazon stated that Project Kuiper's main design goal was to be affordable, the company has not yet disclosed the cost of the internet service. Using low Earth orbit (LEO) satellites, each Project Kuiper receiver will make use of Amazon's system. The first two prototypes of these satellites will be launched later this year on a Vulcan Centaur rocket from United Launch Alliance, even though they have not yet entered production. In order to launch its satellites in 2024, Amazon plans to reach mass manufacturing of its satellites later this year. By the end of 2024, clients should be able to begin using Project Kuiper. The items already available on the market from Starlink are the obvious comparison, and the two rivals share many similarities. The products range from portable, like the Starlink Roam, to commercial, and they're both based on the same LEO satellite technology. Yet it should be noted that what SpaceX offers are now far more expensive, starting at $600 for the stationary edition of the Starlink Roam and residential offerings. Regarding speed, Amazon is very optimistic about its system, because it might be a lot faster than what Starlink is now providing. According to SpaceX, consumers can expect global internet speeds between 300 megabits per second and 350 megabits per second for commercial users. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.